Okay. Hi everybody, it's Ryan here. I've got this golf cart finished, so I'm gonna just do a summary video of everything I've done to it. So, here's the golf cart. It's a 1968 Harley Davidson, and I got it from a family member, and it was working at the time, and it was white, and had white seats, and I used it for a little bit, and got it running, and so I invested some time and money to fix up most of the fiberglass. That one was fixed, but it got broken, and painted and put on the boat seats. I put on this truck box liner, which was pretty good, and then I made it so that I took some old pull golf carts and tried to mount it on the back, and then on the bottom I put this little shelf, which will come in handy. But so that was all just cosmetic stuff on the outside. The real interesting part is what was done on the inside. So a lot of people take early Yamahas and older Harley Davidsons and put in Predator 420 engines because they're four stroke, which is what I wanted because we have an orchard and I wanted a practical getting around type of vehicle, not one that was giving me a lot of grief. So that other engine worked for a while, then lost compression. I put a new top end in, then one day I accidentally wrecked that cylinder too, which is my own fault, but I was tired of messing around with it, so I put in this is from Princess Auto, which is Harbor Freight in Canada, essentially the same store, but this is basically a Predator 212 engine. And so to make it fit in here, the tricky part with this was that the old engine was mounted on an angle, and it's mounted to this subframe, which is separate. You can sort of see how it works here, that it's on the wheels and the rest of it are on the bottom. So what I did is I took all the engine parts out, the clutches out, sold them on eBay, and then took the money from that, bought this engine. It was $150. Now the gas tank wouldn't fit. The gas tank and the air intake wouldn't fit underneath there. So the muffler does fit in this gap here, so that's why it stayed on. But then I also bought this air intake, which is one of those like high flow ones. It's supposed to increase horsepower, but for me it was more important just to be low and coming out the front. And then I bought this fuel pump, which allowed me to use the existing fuel tank, which is great. This particular engine had electric start, so I took those wires, ran them up to the front, and they're connected to this guy. It hasn't run in a few weeks. Getting this mounted to the subframe, I had to weld on a little frame, which you probably see better in some of the videos from the summer, which will probably be following this video once it's all compiled into YouTube. A little battery on the back. The easy part was the engine is a stock four stroke, so I did lose reverse. I used a regular Comet torque converter. I think it's the 30 series, the asymmetrical one. But the real tricky part, and would probably make this hard for others to copy, and if people do have questions, feel free to reach out. But this piece right here, this metal piece, but there will be some more pictures following from this torque converter. Well, I actually had to cut down a weldable hub. I think that's like a 19 tooth weldable hub, and I had to cut it down skinny enough so that I could mount it on there. It goes down to another weldable hub, which is welded onto this little piece. Now this little piece, there's a similar part on the old clutch that could be used, but it's basically just a like sort of a hockey puck with a shaft sticking out of it. It's it's all metal, but I had to get that custom machine. And it was about $200. The torque converter was about $300. This is 100. The engine was 150, so we're up to. In the end, I bought all the stuff for about $800, and I sold all the stuff, the old stuff, for about the same. So, but what's nice about this is I can change this gear ratio between the torque converter and the drive just by taking off this weld-on hub and putting on a different sprocket. And then if I wanted to go faster or slower, I could. Right now it's geared at 30 kilometers an hour. It could actually be geared lower, I think. It can get up to 30, but it takes a long time, and I don't think it ever really gets up to full RPMs. But the nice thing about this is it just bolts on, then the brake's on, and you don't have to mess around with any of that. I did have to change the seal in there. I might have to change the gear seals in here too, but other than that, the rest on the back is the same. Then the only other slightly tricky part was the choke. So that's choke off, and I wanted to be able to use it using the regular choke cable. So what I did is I'm gonna pull this out, and you can watch what happens here. So if I pull on that, then it pulls that back. And the reverse is true too, although it's about -5 or -6 out Celsius. Things are a little stiff. That's how it works. And then you just choke it and away you go. So like I said, you don't have reverse, which at the orchard, in a practical sense, I don't need reverse. I just push it back into the shed. And then secondly, it doesn't shut off when you let off the gas. The engine's just always running. And speaking of the gas, so we'll see. Just as I push this pedal, you can see it pushes the throttle. And so all I did for that was I just ran the gas pedal cable to here, bolted it to where one of these little mounts for the gas tank, and it just pushes this in and out. I think you can buy a foot pedal cable for these engines, but this works pretty good. The only problem is that you don't have a lot of range of motion, so I put some blocks back there to basically stop you from pushing it too far. So I kind of doubt it's going to start with the electric start, because it's -5 or -10 and hasn't ran in 3 weeks, but we'll see. It's also the nice thing about that electric start, and we've used this already quite a bit at the orchard, so the electric start does work nice when it's warm out, and when the engine's warm, it works really well. But we'll try it. It's just a bit dangerous if not sitting on the cart. Yeah, that battery hasn't ran in a while, so I'll shut this video off and I'll see if I can get her going, and then we'll maybe take one action shot before we park it for the winter. Alright, so we got it started. Just a few pull starts with the choke on and played with it a little bit, and then actually once I got it to choke and run for a few seconds, then I was able to sit in the chair with the thing down, use the electric start, and play with the gas pedal to get her going nice. So a couple more things that I gotta do on it. One is either the fuel gauge or the fuel sending unit is no good, and so it doesn't work, but I'm thinking about fixing that. And one other thing, if people are considering using one of these styles of golf carts to put in one of these engines, is that the brake, I leveled out the rear end so that this would all be straight up and down, whereas before the rear end pointed up a little bit. And the problem with that though is then the brake sits about 4 or 5 inches from the ground, so it's just something to be aware of. I'm thinking I might weld some sort of a guard down here, which would help that, or at least protect it a little bit. But out at the orchard, we have pretty flat land, so it's not a big deal. So, close her up. It's not overly quiet, but that's okay, and hopefully you can hear what I'm saying. Got my GPS going. This is from a recent trip. We hit a top speed of 31.8 kilometers an hour, and we went 10 kilometers, so it's not too bad. Which, that's actually pretty close to where we had geared it. But, just take it for a rip and see how it goes. Yeah, I've never done snow golf, car driving, so it's pretty slippery out here. An hour. If I think running it lean over a long time is a problem, then I'll gear it lower to give it a bit more torque. But I still want the torque converter to do its job. So maybe having a little more torque. You can't burn out with this guy. Everybody, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments, or I have a post on Buggies Unlimited as well, or a thread that you can follow. I can post that in the link. And then, like I said, yeah, maybe a separate video where I'll put sort of the shots I took as I was building it over the last few months. So yeah, this video might have got a bit too long, so I might put them in a separate one. But, yeah, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. And I'm looking forward to using this, but it did take a lot of time. So if you are thinking about it, I definitely recommend actually going with, like, one of those Yamaha G1s, where you can just toss in the, where it basically just mounts straight to it. This took a lot of thinking and engineering, but thanks again for watching. Let me know what you think in the comments. Thanks.